Hey, hey, that was Uzo Zisola by Amos or DJ Maporisa. Good morning and welcome to 959 Breakfast with your host, Roo. I'm with Dineo and Saul. And we are together here, I think, for the longest run, won't we? Till 9 o'clock?
Yay!
Spoken like a captain.
Hey. Hey, Meneer Lucas Khadibi.
How are you, Dineo?
I'm fantastic.
How you're looking great. You're looking good.
Thank you. I'm looking like you. Fresh. Hey.
No.
Love it. Hey. Yeah. Welcome. Thank you. No, look thank at you.
Yeah, no, thank you very much.
Saul,
yeah,
how you feeling?
Me. Man, I'm starstruck, you know. Yeah. I'm a huge fan, legend. Yeah. I mean, for me, Lucas Radebe is up there, top five best South Africans of all time.
Yeah.
After Mandela, maybe right after Mandela. So
Jesus Christ,
can you imagine how much I feel? That's what you mean right to me, man. Yeah.
Don't put me under pressure, my man.
No pressure. No pressure at all. Well done on that opening link. Well done.
You're
born
amazing.
For radio. Nicely done. We're going to ease you into it. We're decoding Lucas Radebe this Thursday. You know, every single Thursday, we decode somebody that's very special to you, near and dear to your heart, and a country darling. One that we always, like, truly, truly want to know more about. 16 minutes after 6. First things first. We're talking career choices for our children. Talu, when you look at your career and how you feel about your career, is this something that you would encourage your children to jump into?
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, with us it's different because we grew up in a time when we were advised, you know, by our parents, you know, what career do you have to take. And today, you know, I mean, they've got so much option.
Absolutely.
You know, and now they got to choose. Yeah, they got to choose their own careers, and that's what I say to most of the kids. You know, do what you love most, and do what you're passionate about, and something that will actually make you change. You can't just have a career, you know, where for the sake of it, do something that will leave a legacy, do something that will actually impact. You know.
Perfect.
Yeah, very impactful, you know, which is very, very important for me. And go for it. Once you have it, give 100%.
Lovely. Ladies and gents, looking at your career and how you feel about your careers, you have kids, would you encourage them to hop on board, whatever it is that you're doing now for a living? Criminals, as advised when I speak to Khomozo, please stay out of this one. This one is not for you, okay? If you're thugging it out in life, Don't partake.
I would. Mm-hmm. I think, you know, I'd allow my kid. And also, I think with this line of work, because ukhuluma kakhulu naye, and she's very smart. So why not, you know?
Yeah, I
would.
Like
I wouldn't necessarily force her, but if she were to say, I want to be in the entertainment space, do what you do, Dad, I'd definitely support her. In fact, I'll be a guest on her show.
Yeah, same. I'd also encourage my kid and pop.
There was a point we had a conversation with Tata about this. He wanted to had ambitions of being a footballer, and I said good luck with that, but the one thing I would not do is discourage him. If that's what you want to do, that's what you want to do. I've never been that parent that feels like we were talking the other day, living vicariously through your children. So I would never do that. So if that's what he wants to do, go for it.
Nazi.
I don't know, I don't have children, so I don't know who I would, you know, encourage. But thinking of my life and where I am, I feel like I don't even know where I am in life. So I don't know. But I would encourage my child, whatever they decide to do. Mm-hmm. But I don't know if I'd say, hey, maybe you should do this or don't do this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. I feel like I'm a... Yeah.
It's a tricky one.
I look at my career holistically and I'm like, this is such a fun playing field. And you get to make money from making fun.
You get paid to have fun.
You get paid to have fun and change people's lives and influence people positively. Definitely go ahead, do it.
Exactly. Yeah, Dina. I think, you know, with us it's different.
Yeah.
You know, we've been in the... we've had such a great careers in football.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And some of the kids... I've got a... No, I'm not going to say how many kids I have, but...
No stress. Don't you worry. We'll probably get there anyway.
I have boys. Yeah. So they want to follow my footsteps.
Yeah.
Which is a difficult thing, you know, to say...
Especially in this country.
In this country.
Yeah.
You know, the expectations.
Yeah.
You know, when now I've got about two of them who wants to play football.
Mm-hmm.
And... Yes, I want to. So I'll love to support them by all means.
Of course.
You know what I mean? And I do so all the time. But, you know, sometimes you can look at them. Yeah, you look at them and you're thinking, he's got such big feet to fill. Yeah, such a big shoes to fill.
Yeah.
Will he make it? Yeah. You know what I mean? But, you know, those are some of the things that we ponder about, you know, all day. And then I look at them and I'm thinking, look, why don't we maybe look at something else? It's an option, you know what I mean?
TikTok or something.
TikTok, yes, I see what you did there.
Yeah, when you talk about TikTok. No, I know where you're heading to.
It's 20 minutes after 6. We're decoding the big Lou, Mr. Lucas Radebe. It's going to be an absolute enjoyable one. Tell a friend to tell a friend to tell another friend. Spread it all over WhatsApp. Tune in. He's here for 3 hours all the way till 9. First things first, please do drop us those voice notes. Looking at your career and the work that you do, how you feel about it. Would you encourage your child, if they wanted to follow in the same path, would you encourage your child to do so? Drop us those voice notes. You know the line, you know the drill. 063-688-0959-640. Do you ever party? Mr. Khadidi?
Yeah, I do party.
Really?
Yeah, not as much as I want to, but you know.
What's keeping you from proper partying? Discipline,
career obviously.
Commitments.
Yeah, I think, you know, throughout my career, I think one of the things, you know, it's been discipline.
Yeah.
You know your limits.
Absolutely.
You know, and how far you want to go with. And I've got a lot of friends, eh?
Mm-hmm.
And they hate me sometimes, you know, when I go out with them.
Why?
Because when it starts getting hot and... You know, and vibe, and I want to leave.
Yeah.
I leave.
You actually leave. You don't lie even.
Oh, you're one of those friends.
No, I'm not going to stay until 12 o'clock or wait for the club to
close.
Switch on the light and say, guys, last round. No. No chance, no.
I love that. I absolutely love that. So you should be nicknamed literally the people's captain. I mean, I think, right? The people's captain. That's what you want to us. Definitely the people's captain. How did it feel every time you touch the ball and the entire stadium screams in unison? That must be insane.
Goosebumps.
Yeah, no, it's
like the minute the
amazing.
Ball is on the tip of your toes, everyone.
And even if I'm doing something not even special, you know what I mean?
It's just
a slight tackle.
That's your special. That was your specialty.
It was, but. I mean, it's very special to hear the fans, especially, I mean, it's just a little touch of the ball, you know, just even if you don't even touch it, you know, but
the fact that the ball is coming.
Yeah, but that means I'm doing the right thing, so
true.
Yeah, yeah, but I think I've been blessed, to be honest, with the talent, and obviously for the fans to be taken to that far, I think I've done well.
You have.
I must have done something right.
Absolutely. Where does that name come from, Roo? Because, I mean, you are Lucas, so it's understandable to say Lou.
Yeah. No, but Lou is a threat. Yeah, the Lou is something else.
Think about the Lou. Where does Lou come from?
Hey, no, I think... It comes from the fans, to be honest, you know.
They just decided they're going to call you Roo.
Yeah, I think the Lou came in and I thought, Jesus, that can't be right. But then Ben Roo come up, I think, from Kha. Because Lou comes from Lucas.
Yes.
It will come from Lucas, it will make sense. And then apparently, you know, it changed.
So why don't they go Kha?
No, but it's absolutely brilliant to hear. You know, I have some of the white guys who come to me and says, but why are they booing you?
Because it's
sounds like
yes. It sounds like boo.
I always thought you and Matthew Booth were getting booed.
Yeah.
Also
yeah.
Booth was booed.
Yeah, yes. Yeah, yes. Yeah, yeah. No, which is great, but I had to explain, you know, because they don't get it properly.
Well, I mean, we were talking about our children and encouraging them in their careers, and you did mention that two of your sons are into football, and you have those fears because there's...
Three. Is it four? No, I'm joking.
Is it seven?
Squad.
I don't know.
The squad song.
Is it 21? I don't know.
You never know, right?
Well, the ones he knows of. I'm just joking.
What kind of one you let you
leave? You're going to leave it there.
You know, they're not mine. They're named after me.
The whole town.
Legacy.
The which is the
legacy, you're going to leave
absolutely.
It there. This is Truth and Love by Tupac Shakur, the late great. May he continue to rest. 6:50 on the dot. We're decoding the people's captain, Lucas Radebe. What an honor, sir. What a pleasure. I think Sol and I both feel very special, as well as our listeners, that you're a great gent. Like, brand-wise, you're great. You know, legacy-wise, you're great. In terms of yourself and your character, you're great. You woke up in the morning. Woke up in the morning to come and share this day with us, this morning with us. And I think even our listeners, I speak on behalf of them. Thank you.
Thanks.
Thank you very much to you guys. I mean, it's an honor, you know, to wake up to, you know, to see these beautiful faces.
Oh, thank you.
And to be honest, people that have really, you know, been behind, not just the brand, but the person itself.
Absolutely.
You know, and, you know, we don't get a chance or enough time to talk to people and say thank you, you know, for all the support and opportunities like this, you know, they give us that chance, you know, to talk to people and share, you know, your life or to share your career with everyone else and to say thank you. To be honest, you know, for the contribution.
I find this very ironic for a footballer. Right, obviously, how many people make up a football team?
11.
11.
Yeah, I saw you going.
And
12.
12.
No, I'm joking. Sometimes I don't have a clue what's going on.
Yes,
I love football. But now,
funny enough, you form part of 11 players on the field. You are one of 11 children in your family, and your whole career was all about position playing. What position did you play in the family?
You know, I've always said that you know, I was so privileged.
Yeah.
No, actually, for me, I think football was a calling. Do you know,
I can believe that.
I mean, for what I've achieved and what I've gone through the game, it's absolutely amazing. I was playing that midfield defense in the family.
Explain that. Midfield defense in the family.
I was number four in the row.
Oh, you were the fourth one.
I'm the fourth in the row. Yeah, I had my brothers, my older brothers, and my sisters. Mm-hmm. You know, who had to, you know, respect.
Yes.
You know, and obey.
Course.
You know, which was nice though. You know, I mean, growing up in a big family, it was great fun.
Yeah.
Nerilwalela the position. Go, yes. Whether because we grew up in a four room.
Mm.
So the boys had to sleep go kitchening, the girls go dining room, and only my older brother had a bedroom.
Ah.
Arubala Ali, why no? Not sharing this with anybody. Arubala Ali one. So now we had to.
Anal Dijara Zagai Ganabo.
Slech.
Eh?
Anal Dijara Zagai Ganabo.
He's an older brother. So
he's
you
the
have
first
to,
one.
Yeah, he's the first one.
Keep yeah, Margadi Nogoto, Nalina
Jara Zagai. Yeah, possibly. Anal Botedi something.
Anal Moholi.
Yeah, Nasal Moholi. So you can't argue with that. So Ran Nerluanela. The position go kitchening go tasata fule go pila stove.
That's wild.
Yeah, but it was great because my mom and dad were very strict.
Is it?
Yeah, very very strict. Yeah. And my dad was worse because nelimtu to hang early. Kabo 4 miracle. he used to transport people and goods from here to Rustenburg.
Mr. Logistics.
Yes, wherever. So when he wakes up, everybody has to wake up, especially the boys.
It's okay.
Well, of course, he has to walk past.
The cars has to be cleaned.
Yeah.
It was quite hectic.
What did that instill in you?
I think discipline and respect. I think, you know what? The thing is that we grew up with values, you know, and to be honest, and we took them for granted as we grew up. You know, our parents instilled them in us, you know, making sure that, you know, everything you do, you don't take shortcuts. Respect the elders, whatever. You're going to have to respect the elders. Whether it's your neighbor, next door, you're going to have to respect them. You know, you don't do things in front of the elders.
True.
You know, and obviously how to treat the elders as well. You know, now we're going to have to you know, you're going to have to wake up early. You're going to have to do your chores. You know, whether you or you're going to have to get things ready for your parents. Tea. You're going to have to wake up early and clean. You know, and obviously for Rumiwa.
You said your dad would deliver stuff for Rustenburg. Is that then possibly is that connected to how you ended up in Zirast, which is, I mean, it's the same side?
No, you know, it's strange how I ended up in Bukutatswana.
Bukutatswana back then.
Luhurutse.
Luhurutse.
To be precise, yeah, Luhurutse.
Okay.
My older brother used to play football. Actually, Unali, he was the best. Yeah, but he played at the wrong time.
Wow.
You know, kind of put it at a party. There wasn't a lot of opportunities as well then. And he left. He got called up to come to the Northwest. I think it was a principal school. So they were looking for players, and most of the players they went over. So as well, they called him up to come up and join them. And he left, but he didn't last long. No. And how it came up he came home one of the weekends. And whatever Nelibatwa Bamhawula. So he came at home for the weekend, and then when he was supposed to leave, he was AWOL. He went AWOL, and my mother said Natsurikil Botol. And the kina could say it's the 80s, it was the riot.
Yeah.
So my mother said, take this one.
I school long.
Yeah, but says take this one. I school long. Wapula nil ta matsaru pass one pass all. Na kosa thing. Says that's how I left.
That is so interesting.
The club, yeah.
And the culture shock when you get there, I'm sure the ladies were like, "Yo, he's the guy from Joburg." You're a ladies' man.
Ka afro limangina.
I'm telling you.
Chamo boy.
Charming all of us right now. 6:58. We're headed to top of the hour news. On the flip side of the news, we're looking for our 959 breakfast champs. Hey, little champs, we're hanging with a true champ this morning, a soccer champ of note, an icon living. So if you want to hang out with Uncle Marawena, I think go by name Barufone lang. Oh, grandfather. We're not grandfather.
I mean, your son was sitting there and he was Uncle Primo, so you can't be Uncle.
There's no
Lucas.
Way you can't be Uncle Lucas, because now I'm 12, I'm 9, I'm 1.5. So I'm not away now, but not away. I'm Uncle. Grandpa Lucas.
That's out of respect.
Dada Mokholo Lucas, Auntie Dineo, Uncle Saul. Give us a call.
Hey, we're all aunties. Uncles and aunties.
Kaya 959, on the street, on the air, we are 959 Breakfast. Tandubuntu and Dineo Ranaka. Yes.
You got mother name, yeah?
Yes. He did tweet, actually. I must let you know. the Lucas that this one tweeted that he would like to use his other name more often.
Oh.
Yeah, and he got a number of likes on that one. So his other name is Tandubuntu.
Tandubuntu.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, Tandubuntu. Yeah. Yes.
I love Ubuntu, you know, and people getting along. Yes. Which leads me to the question, Dalu. So you were signed at Leeds as a plus one, essentially, right?
Plus one.
You're a plus one, essentially, right? Phil Masinga was the actual assignee. Then you became the main player and the star. Yeah. And you guys are boys. Didn't that create some sort of friction between the two of you? Did you sit down and talk about it?
That's a good question. That's where the juice
is. Know, before actually leaving the country, you remember there was a game when we played. Phil played for Cosmos.
Yes, he did, yeah. Scout Ocho Movele, yeah.
And I played for Kaiser.
Yeah.
And when the two teams met, it's always been Lucas versus Phil.
Eish.
So there's
not the teams.
Not the teams, yeah. And there's an incident that happened in one of the games. Mm-hmm. He elbowed me.
Eish.
He elbowed me badly that I ended up on the floor. Apparently, a lot of people said I nearly swallowed my tongue and something like that. So, and then the move happened.
Ooh.
Then the move happened.
Now you're stuck with him. Now I'm stuck with him.
Did you guys fight after the elbowing?
Pardon?
Did you guys fight after the elbowing?
No, we fought in the field, actually. We fought in the field. And even after the game, Sizwe. And yeah, Sizwe and him, Phil, said they went looking for me in Deep Kloof to fight me.
Maybe that's why they call you Roos, King Fighter.
I'm not a fighter, so I was always hiding. You know what I mean?
Is it?
Yeah.
So now you're flying stuck.
So now we're up at Leeds together.
And then?
Stuck in the same place.
What broke the ice?
To be honest, we laughed about it.
Yeah.
Yeah. We chatted about it because we stayed in the same place in the they call it the digs.
Yeah.
Yeah. In the same house.
Yeah.
Yeah. We shared a bedroom.
That is
can
wild.
Can imagine how.
That is wild.
You guys shared a bedroom.
We shared a bedroom.
That
yeah. Yeah.
So wild.
And we'll stay up and chatting and you know and to be honest, you know, we ended up forgetting about what was happening, what had happened before, and look to our careers at Leeds.
Listen to that.
Iyaphela. We all find a way
to find a common ground, but I suppose you had to be professional.
We had to and as well we found ourselves in a strange place.
Yeah,
you know,
you only had each
foreign,
other
so we had it was just me and him. And the conditions were harsh. It was freezing cold.
Yeah,
you know, when we got the that's what hit us, you know, the weather. The food, I mean, you can imagine.
No juangwa.
I don't know, Yorkshire pudding.
And Sunday roast.
Sunday roast. Green peas.
Mashy peas.
Mashed potato,
even then.
Mashy peas. Scampi. Hospital food. Oh. It's just terrible.
Yeah, no,
7:30. I mean, can we get this man a decent breakfast after all of this?
Guys, Bob Mautwana, someone.
Somebody deliver something. I mean, we've got a king in the building who does not clearly want mashy peas. We're going to the news desk with Nosi Radebe. Indeed, on the street, on the air, and definitely in the depth, or nearly in the depth of 30 seconds, decoding Lucas Radebe. Are you ready?
Hey, I am. I'm here.
Our laptops must close now. We're about to play a serious game. Laptops must close. 30 seconds. I'm the timekeeper.
We're playing
on air today.
Okay, cool. So he's going to start. Dalu's going to start, right?
How do we play this thing?
Okay,
you grab a card.
You're really letting me do that alone.
You grab a card and then you give clues. So we must, without giving us the word on the card.
Just clues.
Yes.
Describe what's on the card without telling us what's on the card.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure his name is probably on one of the cards.
He'll just say me. So
I'll say.
Let's come. As I turn this over, we must all go. Yeah. And you, wherever you are, who's listening, wherever you are, we must all go.
Yes.
Okay, let's go.
Yes.
Okay, he's got a card now.
He's got a card.
Where?
Money.
You can say it.
You can speak, just don't say the word. You can give clues verbally. You can give clues verbally.
You can speak.
You can speak.
Football. Say what you
can. We can't read sign language. Yes.
Counting numbers. Five.
No, you can
six.
Speak.
You can say you what
you can give the clue. You don't have to act the clue out.
You can speak.
Tell my clues.
You can speak. You can tell us what it is that you're doing right now.
Okay. Want to know?
Yeah.
No, we are mime.
Yes, you can speak. You can speak.
Is it big? It is a bank. I'm saying saying number 11. 12 is more distinct in reserve.
But you're not saying, you're showing.
Number 12.
Yeah, you must tell us.
Should I tell or should I just?
No.
I was like, no. Number 10, number 12.
But you weren't saying it.
Number 12 reserve.
Guys, I need to paint this picture. You're going to see this on kai959.co.za. This guy stood up to mime.
We are mime. We are sign language.
Your new name is about to be Jumaima.
Rumaima.
He's playing charades.
He's
playing charades.
Oh, the charades. Yes. Okay.
Do you want another try?
Yeah, let's go. Okay, another,
let's switch.
Try.
Let's switch. Okay.
You give them a clue.
Yes. For every time you pick a card and I switch the little hourglass, we go rude.
Let's try that again.
We're giving him another chance. Okay.
Aha. Let's go. It's a bank.
Absa.
It's a bank.
Which one?
No, the other one. It's a
FNB.
Bit green.
FNB. Oh,
Nedbank.
Yes.
South Africa. Who we are after Madiba? After Madiba, who we became?
Rainbow Nation.
There's a nice, you know, the English, the UK TV show involving cars.
Top Gear.
The place. You know, this was, they were fighting, the soldiers. You know,
Hiroshima.
Yes. Hiroshima, Vietnam.
Hiroshima was the bombing.
The bombing.
Yeah, it's classic.
Not bad though.
That was much better.
Yeah, I know him not. Can you play again?
Yes.
We could do another. Let's do one.
The last one.
He's warming up. He's getting better at this. Okay, cool.
Let's go.
All right, on the count.
Yes.
Pick a card.
Wait.
Pick a card.
After picking the card, then you can.
Okay.
Hands over.
Yes. The games.
Olympic Games.
The Lalwaning.
Winter Olympic Games.
Winter. You find this building called Russia. It's red.
Russia.
It's a pill. It's a pill for
Viagra. Yes.
Blue pill.
Should I change?
Yes.
Tour de France.
Tour de France.
Look at Robert Downey. Do you know who is Robert Downey?
Iron Man. The actor.
Bohemian Rhapsody.
Aki Queen. Bohemian Rhapsody. Queen.
Well done.
Yeah, I should have picked up that.
Well done. I'm impressed. Let's go to something else. Something else that could possibly be something that might get you trending. I'll save this one for later. I think you need to take a break from all the games. We're coming back with another game. It's a musical game. We'll be back.
This is Lucas Radebe, and I'm on 959 Breakfast with Dineo and Saul on the street.
Hey, let's wrap. Let's go.
959 Breakfast with Dineo and Saul.
Bafana. In the area. Come on. Benny McCarthy, where are you, my friend? Kali Papani. And Maguila Halak. Halagasha. I'm not supporting I'm not going to support you. Are you okay? Hunted in your own pick. We need a female voice. Like a machine. Bafana bafana bangena siye France hey wena idogi isitha bashapho kula yini tsonto utsho kula yini lewo kula yini kula le vuvuze kula vuvuze hi Steve Compella should come in and take Bafana. What do you think, Dineo? So,
absolutely.
You think so?
Steve Compella must come and take Bafana. And drop a quote at the end of the match. It's going to be a big one between Kaizer Chiefs and Pirates.
Aye, yes, the big derby.
The big derby. What happened at the big derby last night?
Aye, who's your money on? Who's your money on?
My
you
money
support on. Football.
Who's playing in the big derby?
Jackie! Pirates Chiefs?
Hi, my money's on Chiefs.
Jeez, obvious.
Who's your money on?
Obvious.
I don't know. Whoever wins. This nowadays, I'm not sure. I'm a cozy for life.
There we go. That was fun.
Oh, man.
That was fun.
Yeah, you put me on the spot.
I know, right? Jeez. When are you dropping a single, sir?
Very soon. Who's going to be producing?
So,
come on.
You owe us a song. Benny gave us a song. Licolea gave us a song.
I know, eh?
I'm
not gonna repeat UPU. No chance. I'm not gonna go UP. I don't know. Rapper or get a rapper castwa.
Yes.
You know
what?
But we'll see.
Well,
Watch the space.
Kagabundu is a producer. He's gonna call you into studio, drop it, make it big.
No, for sure. But the you guys should you need a female backing. You need a female voice in that.
I've got a very big male voice, so maybe we should find somebody else who sounds like a female.
Yeah, no, for sure. No,
yeah.
But
yeah.
It's okay. That's a voice that we need, actually.
How he butchered that song. I it's besides me. I love it.
Yeah, you love it, eh?
Yeah,
yeah, but I think I can get remix. It's a remix.
And Nelly freestyle. You killed it. Freestyle.
Hi. You know what? I'm telling you, my God. Record the thing. Put it on CD. See, I'm telling you, Baba. Aye.
Can I tell you something, sir? You are very addictive.
This is a fact.
Just been saying to you that what a beautiful experience getting to spend some time with you outside of the norm.
Yeah.
Because the norm is like, you know, it's so serious and, you know, always so extremely professional and never seen the side of you that you actually get down and play and, you know, have a huge sense of humor, you know, and you can be a clown for 2 seconds. I love this. So thank you for sharing this part of yourself with us.
No, you know, as I was saying when Dineo, not a lot of people will actually expect this from me.
Yes.
You know,
yes. Or believe that this was you.
Or believe that it's me, you know?
Yeah.
And to be honest, it's a great relief, you know, when
I'm glad.
When you get to some places you need to be like
yeah.
a bit formal. But here, you know, it's a good environment. It's good fun.
Yeah.
We never get to do stuff like this. You know, and I got to be myself.
I got to be myself,
you know.
That's
so which is great. I mean, we miss these kind of things.
Yeah.
I'm telling you the truth. You know, most of us as footballers, we, I don't know whether maybe Ranaka nor Batubajwang, but we love to have fun.
Yeah.
We need the time to have fun with people. I've met some kids and most of them say, but you know, we never thought you were a real person. You know,
I mean,
seriously, you know, you meet some little kids and you shake hands, and some of them older people, and they say, but is it true? You know, and they pinch themselves, and I pinch myself as well, thinking about how are these people thinking
you're not real.
I'm not, you know.
I think it's because of the how we look up to people like you, right? So your superstar, your superstardom becomes such a big deal, and you are celebrated on such a big stage that we forget that you're human. And I mean, the football fraternity, it's prestigious.
Yeah.
It's really, really prestigious. You can't take it for granted. No, you can't take it lightly. It's really, really prestigious. So you walk into rooms all suited and kitted. And also, I mean, the way you look, it's like, my God, this guy is a gent, you know?
But also, thanks to social media, we get to see that side of you now. Because I've seen, I mean, you're a family man. I mean, with your girls on TikTok, you know, you're very, like, playful. Yeah. And, you know, you can, you're down to earth. What's the difference, actually? Like, what's different about Lucas, the boy dad, and the girl dad?
To me, you know, kids are kids. You know, I think I'm a bit lenient with the girls, to be honest.
Of course.
Which father isn't?
You know what?
Yeah.
I mean,
girls,
Jesus.
Man.
I think they're my angels.
Yeah, of course.
Kiss of sports.
Yeah. You. Too much.
Yeah.
Too much. Yeah. They get away with a lot.
A lot of murder.
They get away with a lot. But, you know, the thing is that through my career, I've never had a chance to see my kids growing up.
Of course.
Do you know what I mean? And you never get to see their personalities as they grow up. You know, that bond, you know, this is the time now that, you know,
you
I have to get to enjoy the kids and do stuff with them, you know? And most of the time I was away traveling. Sometimes it get to a point where if I wear a jacket, if I wear trousers, and they say, but where are you going? You know, my little one would say, Daddy, where are you going? You know, even if I'm not going anywhere.
But because they used to be going,
that's a sign that you're about to leave normally.
About to leave, you know? Yeah. So I enjoy that. And to be honest, this is a blessing. You know, this is one thing that it's natural for me. You know, I don't force it. You know, it just happens. And it's one thing that changed my life, to be honest.
Lovely, lovely. I've got a surprise for you.
Surprise?
There's somebody on the line. You have to guess who this is. Dumelang, Sanbonan, good morning. Legai.
Who's this? Kikesurgimang.
It sounds like Kikesurgimang. Good morning. You, mister, on the line. Hello.
Good morning, good morning.
Talk to your...
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Say a little bit more.
Talk to Taru here.
Eita?
Yeah, well, I guess that you're hosting a very, very prolific legend there.
Yes.
A legend that is taking care of his agenda, and the legend that is inspirational to the youth. Very humble young man. And I must say that
Umang.
He designed his own path, because, you know, he designed his own path. When he came to join the big team here in Gauteng from the other side of another province, I thought to myself, this skinny boy is gonna.
Hey, I'm talking. Yippee, yippee. We've been I'm doing it. That's a great, that's a nice surprise. Actually, we were this, we were viewing the docky.
Oh, were you guys viewing the docky?
Yeah, we
yes. Doc, you've got a docky. Yes, you've got a docky on Mzansi Magic, yeah?
He won.
Yes, I do.
Yes, it's winning. When did it start airing?
I started last Saturday.
Last week, Saturday. Yeah. Congratulations on that. Yeah, congratulations.
Congratulations, Doc.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah,
that's
with Lucas, guys, I must say, it's entirely to the upcoming youngsters if they're not going to follow in his footsteps and, you know, create and make themselves heard out there because that's what he did. Under those circumstances that he find himself, but I must say that he managed to pop up and to become one of the best, because also he was carrying our flag in South Africa, in Europe, and you know, for him to be my teammate, we actually ended up being brothers, you know, because we're so close, even though, you know, growth sometimes tend to create that a little bit of distance between each other. But I must say that whenever he has something at home, or ID, you know, will always embrace each other. So, Luki, I must say, brother, you've done so well. It's good that we celebrate you while you're still alive, because some of our brothers that are no longer here, they're so rest in peace, you know, we've never done that. And I would have loved, you know, to see guys like you, the late shoes, feel, you know, being embraced by our association. Because the youth is going astray, because we don't have reference. And it's out there, but we don't have it. We don't use it, make use of it. So we actually doing things in isolation and also doing things not in encouraged, because you looked up to go to Mosul, not this, you know, the list is endless. But why is it that while we're still alive, we're not being utilized in order for our youth to walk a path that we walked? But having said that, just want to say all the best, boy. You're the man.
That's nice.
He got goosebumps.
Literally, you can see it in the studio.
Yeah, he was rubbing his arms. This is beautiful. Dr. Kumalo, that was, yeah.
Yeah, no.
Umtunga.
You know, if there's someone who's really, you know, put South Africa on the map, and not just South Africa, but he made a football jersey, you know, he's been a trendsetter, you know, that's him. I remember when I first came to Kaizer Chiefs, this is one of the guys that I looked at and I'm thinking, oh my God, that's him. Wow. You know, and I mean, his personality as well, it's absolutely amazing. As he says, that, you know, we're very close. I've got the utmost respect for he knows as well. You know, whether I function, I go. You know, that's brotherhood, you know, and you know, the feeling between the two of us, it's absolutely amazing. And even today, I mean, the weekend when I went to, I had the most hectic weekend ever, but I couldn't miss out that
the premiere of
the premiere, but
his documentary.
Yeah, I think he's done well. Yeah, never mind the singing and stuff, but you know, but he's one of the greats, you know, that leads by example still.
Well, it's in your eyes when you say it. Your eyes do change when you speak of it.
He's one of the guys that I hold very high.
Yeah,
you know, who's played a big part in my career. You know, starting from Kaizer Chiefs. I mean, for me it was an honor to have him at my testimonial. You know, in Leeds. You know, just to have him around.
You've shared a lot.
I think we've shared a lot, and he's amazing. He's amazing,
Mr. Kumalo. You're still on the line. I can hear you. How does that sound, hearing this from your brother?
Well, I'm very humbled, and I must say that if the captain talks, and if the captain is actually giving accolades, you know, you must know very well that he did impress. Because remember, these are the guys that were our leaders on the field and off the field. And with Luchi having a testimonial indeed for him to have invited me and my singer, he saw us into that on his own, because because I never expected Lucas to ask me to come play in his testimonial game in league. And wow, that's unbelievable. But having said that, beyond, you know, even outside football, I must say that he has carried himself very well, because he's still a relevant brand within the industry and even beyond borders. You know, he's also part of the FIFA contingent, and he has tremendously worked very, very well. But the problem, Lucas, not a bit too much, man. Even myself, I get puzzled. Is this Lucas? No, maybe. Then I'll just look twice.
It's hard for them more.
Thank you so much, Dr. Khumalo. We really appreciate it, Mdoma. All the best with your documentary and everything else. And Raleboha Rutso, and just, you know, spread the love and spread some respect on the brotherhood. It's 22 minutes after 8. Saul's got your traffic. 959 Breakfast on the street, on the air. Kaya 959, we're completely calming all the way down. Do you feel the Zen energy taking over you? Do you feel it? This is the moment where we put you, Lucas, in the meditation room. I have created this environment to be conducive for your fast thinking. Okay. Messi or Ronaldo?
Ronaldo.
Doctor or shoes?
Jesus Christ, that's hard. Doctor.
Jabu Bule or Steve Kombela? Steve Lokolea?
Jabu.
Itukune or Brian Baloyi?
Spider-Man.
Spider?
Mourinho or Pep?
Pep.
Ah, where? Thank you. How did that feel in the meditation room?
That's brilliant.
That was a therapy session that you much needed, isn't it?
Yeah.
You can make clear and decisive decisions in your life, isn't it?
For sure. I've been decoded, guys.
You've
been decoded.
Yes. Yeah, absolutely.
Amazing one.
Absolutely. Wow. So you seem to be a lover of love. I'm talking personal romantic love.
For sure.
You have been lucky in love twice.
Aye. Yeah, you're right. Yeah.
Yeah, so you were married before your second marriage.
Yeah.
Obviously, cancer was what did you part with your first wife. And you were blessed again with another woman to step into your life and, you know, be your life partner.
Absolutely. I think it's brilliant that I had to live to tell it, you know, or to experience something like this, because I mean, love is one of the great, it's the best thing ever.
Yeah.
I think everyone needs love, whether it's from parents, whether from, you know, and for me, you know, it should be both. Both of two worlds, because I've enjoyed love and experienced the heartache.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had to go back again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that people that way, dear, you know. But again, for me, everything happens for a reason.
Absolutely.
You know, and I believe that we take things for granted.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and we don't love as much as we're supposed to.
We're slightly afraid, right? But guarded.
Exactly.
And selfish.
Very selfish, you know. And and this is the gift. You know, it doesn't take much to do. You just have to allow it to happen.
I love that.
But
I
how difficult.
I love that.
Yeah.
We have officially decoded Lucas. Say it with me.
No, thanks.
You are a ball of fun. You're a classic gent.
Thank you for your time.
No, thank you very much. I think thanks for the opportunity. But can I say love to my family?
Yes,
you know,
please.
My wife,
yes.
Donna.
Please.
My wife, Donna.
Yes.
You know, because we can't be who we are today without them, without their support. You know, my kids, Wami, Hugo, Ufente, Kutluano. I mean, I love my kids. You know, that's for me, especially Wami. I mean, this is the reason why. You know, I do what I do, and do it to the utmost best.
Oh my God, Kelaspon.
Zeniti Kelaspon.
Oh, Zeniti Kelaspon.
Yeah, only three.
Yeah.
There's a big difference.
Yeah, there's a big difference in age.
But what I want to say is that, you know, these platforms, you don't know, guys, how big role you play. We do listen to radio, and we do adore you, and
sometimes
this is. What we love to do, because you don't, sometimes you hear the voice but you don't know the face. Do you know what I mean? And you want to see to put the voice to the face. It's and to see you guys and say thank you, you know, for the opportunities. It's for me, it's great.
We can only say you're welcome,
and
sir.
What an honor. You're welcome.
Huge honor.
No.
Live light, laugh long, love the ones you're with. As you heard, Mr. Radebe appreciates love a lot. Essentially, it is all we have. So look after the ones that love you. Love them the most. Love them the most. If there's anything you do give them love. It's really not hard to do. At your best, have a loving heart. So have a great day further.
Thank you very much.
Uncle T up next. He is decoded. Catch it on Kai 959.co.za.